Hello, I'm Andrea Lewis, and this is The Creative Process.
If you have a personal brand, then social media is your friend. And P.S., we all have a brand.
Today, I want to show you how your personal brand plays a crucial role to your success. If you have a good personal brand, people are willing to pay you more for your product or service.
A personal brand will enable you to meet interesting people and unlock disruptive opportunities. But what if I tell you that a narrative or a personal brand that's not shaped by you will be formed and told by others?
How do you brand yourself and develop an authentic personal brand that's merely an extension of who you are and not a regurgitated version of a competitor that you're trying to mimic? Personal branding is self-expression amplified to influence and command attention.
What makes a good personal brand? It comes across genuine, authentic, unique, effortless, and it makes you money. Here's a few people that I think do an amazing job at their personal brand, and it has changed the course of their careers. Amanda Seales. In the last year and a half, she has completely stepped into her own light by being authentically herself, engaging like crazy on her social media, and it has changed the course of her entire career. My friend Julissa Calderon. She works at BuzzFeed and has now become a recognizable face in the Latin community. And in the last year, I have as well watched her take her personal brand a lot more seriously, become more engaging on her social platforms, and her numbers are growing every single day like crazy. Amanda Stenberg, this is one of my favorite people for personal brand. She came out of the gates being bold enough to just be herself. And all of her jobs in the last little while have been a direct correlation with her taking her personal brand more seriously. Issa Rae, she really doesn't need much explanation. We have all seen her life change with the power of the internet and social media, and as well from Issa taking her own unique perspective more seriously and taking her personal brand seriously. Somebody who I consider the OG of personal brands is Spike Lee. We all know what Spike Lee represents: New York, blackness, art, Brooklyn, the Knicks, and just being bold enough to be himself.
I have met like countless writers and filmmakers and people who are technically like behind the scenes of the entertainment industry, and they always have like the same thought on social media, like, ugh, like keep that over there, like my life isn't interesting anyway, I wouldn't want to be sharing it, nobody wants to see what I'm doing, I'm not doing anything at all. It's all what you make it. You are the creative, like you show me why your life is interesting. We don't know that we want to see it until you give it to us. I've seen so many success stories of the writer that was just working like a random job, but then because their tweets or because of their long Facebook posts or Instagram posts, wherever, they decided to engage. Somebody got to see their actual style of writing. Their voice with the writing is now why, you know, they are the head writer over at such and such. This is the place where you get to have a voice. Like, this is what YouTube is for me. Started doing online and digital and social media solely because I was so recognized for being Hazel on Degrassi, and Hazel didn't have a voice. Hazel didn't get to speak. Hazel was just kind of like the black girl in majority of the scenes and majority of the episodes. And it was very frustrating for me in my later teen years, in my early 20s, for people to recognize me so often and think that I was exactly like her. Think that just naturally, if I was capable of playing her, then I must be exactly like this girl. And I wasn't. I was so much louder, my personality was so much bigger, I just had so much more to say and do than being Hazel for the rest of my life. That was the reason, that was solely the reason why I started anything I did online, was it was just because I needed a space to be able to control how people saw me.
I take my own personal brand super seriously, and I'm constantly analyzing it and making sure that I come across as authentically myself as possible. I want everyone to see who I truly am.
This is the outlet where I get to be my freest self. This is the outlet where I get to do whatever the hell I want. And this is where I get to actually show y'all that some days it's easy, some days it's not, some days it makes no sense, some days it's amazing. This is it. this is the place. And that's also the same thought process that I have on all of my social pages, is this is the place where I get to show you whatever I want. If there's anything that I'm learning in this process and talking to girls who they excel at this space, at social media, at YouTube and all this kind of stuff, is don't overthink it, just do it. Just keep doing it and use this thing for your own benefit. Use this thing for your own business. It's about consistency and it's about doing you. I think about my own goals, my own career path, and it's like, this is what I do. I create content. This is what I do. This is how I'll be living the rest of my life. This is where I feel my happiest, my most fulfilled. This is the calling that God has put onto my life. And so my social pages, I have to treat them like the marketing for Andrea Lewis's life. And her life is as a filmmaker, her life is as a content creator, her life is as a girl that likes makeup, is a girl that likes to build her own self-esteem as well as the self-esteem of people around her. She likes her hair, she likes curls, like this is my life. If you're a content creator, if you're a creative, let me tell you something right now. Get out of your head about social media and just start doing it.
The creative process on why social media is your friend. You can create opportunities, earn more money, connect with like-minded people, and be as creative as you want. Just remember to be yourself.
So, if you are not a subscriber to this channel, I don't even know why you're not subscribed. I literally have no clue as to why you have not hit subscribe. So please do so right now. Also, don't forget to like this video. Your girl needs them likes. And share this video with anybody that you think may enjoy it. All right, see you guys on the next one.
Bye.